Hey everyone, it's Coaster Daddy back today with another video. Today I'm going to be discussing Steel Curtain. This is one of my most anticipated new for 2019 coasters, as it is one of the new coasters I'm actually going to get to ride this year, so I'm definitely really looking forward to this one. Let's dive into this ride and discuss why I think it potentially could be a top-notch coaster. The announcement of Steel Curtain was met with a lot of reserved excitement, and this is also somewhat true with myself, just to be completely honest, because of the many complaints or the many concerns I've heard from other people about this. But Steel Curtain is being manufactured by S&S, and they've had a couple coasters in recent history that have experienced many delays and also just don't really provide the best ride experience overall. And specifically, we're talking about Merlin's Mayhem at Dutch Wonderland and Gale Force at Playland's Castaway Cove. Now, with Merlin's Mayhem, I don't know a whole lot about that ride, but from what I've heard, the delays in that ride were actually more so on the park, as there were things that they weren't really complete with, even though the ride had already been completed. So if you know anything more about that, maybe comment and let me know. But from what I've heard, it was more so the park's doing with not getting that one open on time. But the really concerning one for me is Gale Force. Gale Force opened in May of 2017, and after that season, during the 2017 and 2018 off-season, all of the track had to be completely stripped and replaced with brand new track because the ride was just so rough in its first year. From what I've heard from a couple people online that have ridden it since the retracking, it still really isn't that comfortable. So there seems to be many issues surrounding these brand new S&S coasters, which is kind of concerning. But at the same time, Steel Curtain, I believe, has so much potential within it. As long as it's a very smooth ride and doesn't rattle you around too much, I think this ride is going to be phenomenal, really. I mean, you look at those trains and, you know, you have the lap bars and the whole design of the train is just so open. It just looks so comfortable. And I think Steel Curtain could really be a real winner. And honestly, the very first time I saw the animated POV for Steel Curtain after it was announced, I was actually slightly disappointed at first, but over time I've gotten to really appreciate it, and I am really looking forward to it because I think the layout looks fantastic. And the thing about Steel Curtain, it basically has an RMC layout. You know, you see a lot of these manufacturers are coming up with these new elements now, you know, sort of taken out of the RMC guide because they're trying to compete. And I think that's great for us coaster enthusiasts because we get all kinds of these new exciting rides that we haven't really seen before. I mean, you got that very rare banana roll element on Steel Curtain. And then we've got a cutback, which is a really unique element as well. And then if you look on RCDB on their page for Steel Curtain, they even have the inverted drop on Steel Curtain listed. I'm just seeing this now as a Drachenfire dive drop. So that's a really cool, that's kind of cool there. I like that. Steel Curtain is an absolute monster. This is going to be such a sight to behold at Kennywood. It's just going to dominate the skyline there. 220 feet tall, 9 inversions, lots of really unique elements. And as well as those restraints, I think this is pretty well set to be one of the top rides for 2019. I think it could possibly be the number one new coaster of 2019 myself. Despite the concerns that we all have with Steel Curtain, I really think we need to go into it with an absolutely open mind, which I think a lot of people will. And we just need to see how the ride experience is going to be because there is a lot of uncertainty. But I think with the information we have, you know, the layout, the elements, I think this is all going to come together to make a truly phenomenal ride. I don't think it's going to be like a top 10 coaster in the world or anything like that. I think it could potentially be, you know, like a top 25 or something like that. I think it really does look that good. But what do you guys think about Steel Curtain? Are you all excited to get on this ride? I know I'm really looking forward to getting out to Kennywood this year to ride it. Kennywood's only about a 2.5 hour drive for me, so it's fairly close, and I'll be definitely going to Kennywood at least once this year for sure. So hopefully there's no issues with the opening of the ride. We don't have an official opening date for it yet, but they're making very good progress on this ride, so as long as everything goes pretty smoothly, I would think that it shouldn't be too long after the park opens that we see Steel Curtain up and running to the public. Hopefully everything goes well with this ride because I think it could be a real game changer for SNS, of course Kennywood, and just for the whole coaster industry overall. Because, you know, seeing a park like Kennywood and then they're working with this manufacturer that does have some concerns, but they're also churning out this really amazing looking ride. I think there are some risks being taken here, but I really hope those risks pay out in the end because I think Kennywood has a real winner on their hands. So let me know what you think about Steel Curtain in the comments below. If you guys want more content on roller coasters and amusement parks, I upload at least once a week. So be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and all that. And thank you very much for watching. This is Coaster Daddy. Bye.